Hey guys, welcome back to Six Sister Stuff. Today I'm making French dip sandwiches in your Instant Pot. So I'm Kristen, I am sister number two from SixSistersStuff.com. Now don't worry if you don't have an Instant Pot, I'm going to put a link in the description for you so you can find a slow cooker recipe on how to make this also. But let me just tell you the difference. In the slow cooker, it takes about 10 hours. In the Instant Pot, it's about an hour. If you love French dip sandwiches, making in the Instant Pot is so easy. Now on this channel, I love sharing simple, easy Instant Pot recipes and other recipes too, but the easier, the better. So I use very few ingredients and I make it taste delicious. So if you love watching my Instant Pot videos every single Monday, don't forget to like and subscribe, and of course, share it with your friends so they can get my Instant Pot recipes too. All right, you guys, let's go into the kitchen and make delicious Instant Pot French dip sandwiches.
All right, you're gonna start with a 3-pound roast. Now, it doesn't have to be the best cut of meat because it's your Instant Pot, it will cook well. Next, you're gonna add 2 cans of beef consomme. I think that's how you say it. You can find those in the soup aisle. Then that is all there is to it. You're gonna put the lid on, make sure that it's sealed really tight, and you're gonna put it on sealing, not venting. I like to push the manual button. You can also push the meat stew button if you'd like, but they're pretty much the same. So I go manual and I'm going all the way up to 60 minutes. If your roast is frozen, you can do it for 120 minutes also. Then when it's done, you can either let it release on its own or you can flip it over and do a quick release. Now it's time to pull the lid off and it smells so good. So you can either take your roast out and shred it up or you can shred it right inside of your Instant Pot. Now when you're all done shredding it, you're gonna pull the meat out kind of with a strainer and put it to the side. You're gonna leave the drippings or leave the juice because that's what you're gonna dip your sandwich in. So now I'm getting my subs ready and I'm gonna put my meat right onto my bread. Now notice my bread is on a cookie sheet because I like to broil my cheese. You can put other things on here too. I like to add banana peppers and my husband really loves jalapenos. So I'm making banana peppers for myself and then the jalapeno sandwich for my husband. Next, I'm gonna add some provolone cheese and then I'm gonna take this and broil in the oven for about a minute just so the cheese is melted. Then I'm gonna put my bun back on and dip it into my juice. Now you don't have to add cheese and the other ingredients. You can just put your bun on and dip it in your juice and just eat it just like that. But I like to add just a little bit more flavor. Well guys, that's all I have for you today. Thanks for stopping by on my Instant Pot Monday. I will see you next week. See ya, bye.